Welcome to the beautiful world of operators. So what do you mean by operators? They are the symbols used to perform some specific calculation or manipulate any data or value. So who uses these operators? Operands and expression. Now you'll say, what are these operands and what are these expression? Let's see. So operands are the expressions or the values on which an operator acts or works. Now what are expressions? These are the formula in which the operands are linked or joined to each other by the use of the operators to compute a value. Now let's see some diagrammatic representation of operators, operands and expression. So you can see here in the following diagram. Plus sign is the operator and x and y is the operand. And yes, it will yield a value, it will add the values of x and y and it will give the sum of that. Another example, you can see the plus is the operator, minus is the operator and x and y are the operands and z is the result which will have, which will store the value of the following expressions, of the given expressions. Next, one more example. So, as I told you, again 5 and 10 are the operands and plus and the multiplication are the operator. So, it will yield a result. 5 plus 10 will be 15 and 5 into 10 will be 5050. So, what is an expression? Expression, as I told you, it is a formula. So here I've given a formula. The result will be equal to A plus B into C, where A, B and C are the operand. And plus and the multiplication sign are the operator. And the result is a variable where it will store the value yielded by the expression. Next, coming to the types of operator, there are three types of operator: arithmetic, comparison and logical. Now let's see what are these operators. Arithmetic operators, it takes two operands and performs a calculation on them. Comparison operators, yes, they are also called relational operators. And what it does, it compares the values and return either true or false. Logical operators, it is a symbol or word used to connect two or more expressions based on the comparison operators, and yes, it also returns true or false. Now let's see different types of operators, different types of operators under each operator. So first we'll see the types of arithmetic operator. You can see there are four types of arithmetic operators: plus, minus, multiplication and the division. So next let's see. This is an explanation with an example: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. An operator used the plus symbol, the minus symbol, the asterisk sign and the slash for the division. Next. Now this as arithmetical operator has order of precedence. Now if an expression has more than one operator, then the following order of precedence is followed. If you have heard about the Bodmash rule, this is the rule which is followed. First, whatever expression is given within the parenthesis or the bracket will be executed. Then comes the multiplication and division. Again, it will be performed in order of occurrence from left to right. And then finally addition and subtraction. Again, they are performed in order of occurrence from left to right. So remember, bracket has the most priority. Then the multiplication, division and then addition and subtraction. Here is an example. Let's find the value of D in the following expression where A equal to 10, B equal to 20 and C equal to 30. Now, I have given expression here as D equal to A plus B, which is within the bracket, and then multiplied by C. So we'll write the corresponding values of each variable a, b and c. So we'll write d equal to within bracket 10 plus 20 and then it will be multiplied by 30, which is the value of c. Now since a plus b is the within the bracket, so it will be added first. So we'll get the 30, the value of the expression given within the bracket, and then we'll multiply the value of c, which is again 30. So finally we'll get the result of d as 900. This is the order of precedence maintained in an expression when the number of operators is more than 1. Next, coming to the types of comparison operators. You can see over here there are number of types of comparison operators beginning from equal. So equal to compares one value to the other value. Greater than, it will test whether the value is greater than the certain value or not. Similarly, less than, it will test whether the value is less than certain value or not. Then greater than equal to, it will test whether the value is greater than or equal to the certain value that is given. Less than or equal to, similarly, it will test whether the value is less than or equal to the certain value or not. And not equal to, it will test whether the value, that is a particular value, is not equal to the certain value or not. Okay, next one. So this is an explanation of relational operator or comparison operator. You can see less than 5, less than 2. Yes, 5 is not less than 2. So it will reveal the result as false. Then greater than, yes, 5 greater than 2. Yes, 5 is greater than 2. So it will reveal the result true. Less than equal to, 5 is less than equal to 2, no, neither 5 is less than 2 nor it is greater than 2, nor it is equal to 2. So it will yield the result false, so it will return the value false. 5 greater than equal to 2, though it is not equal to 2, but it is greater than 2, so it will return the result true. Why? Because in case of or, one of the expression have to be true. If one of the expression is true, then it will yield the value as true. It will return the value as true. So here, one of the expression that 5 is greater than 2 is true, but 5 is equal to 2 is false. So finally, it will return the value as true. 5 equal to 2, no, so it returns false, and 5 not equal to 2, yes, so it returns true. Next one. Now coming to the types of logical operators. So there are two logical operators, and or. Now, and, in and, it only returns true if and only if both the expressions are true, otherwise it will return false. In case of or, one of the expression have to be true, otherwise it will return false. Next, now is an example of logical operator. You can see here the value of x equal to x equal to 6 and y equal to 3. Now given here x less than 10 and y greater than 1, yes, because both the expression are true, so it will return the value true. Yes, x is less than 10 and y is greater than 1. And considering the value, again x equal to 6 and y equal to 3, yes, x equal to 5 or y equal to 5, both are false, so it will return the value false. So that's all. I hope you have understood what are the operators. So thank you for watching.